Welcome to this quick getting started video with Hasura, where we're going to look at the key concepts that will help you be able to understand what Hasura does, how it does it, and what makes it a little bit different than your typical solution. To understand that, we want to look at Hasura through three layers. First, there is the metadata, then there is the console, and then there is the engine. Underneath everything that Hasura does, we have a declarative metadata that defines the relations across your data. Beyond just relations, it also defines permissions and the connections to those data sources. Imagine, if you will, that I have a Postgres database here with orders and users and their products. Now imagine over here, I have browsing history from BigQuery. Those don't share any natural boundaries in terms of their underlying data structures, but they do share a semantic relation that I care about as a product designer. So to federate those and connect them, I need to define in a secondary platform how I'll connect these two so that I can query across them in a single query and get all that data to complete my data picture. That's where metadata comes in. I can define how do these connect, as well as how do I connect to them. And then when I write a query, in this case GraphQL, to my system, it'll actually resolve that data to the different systems, however you speak Postgres or however you speak BigQuery, and then federate the data source together and return it back to my user. That's what the metadata does, is it provides a declarative approach to defining what we refer to as the data layer. The console is a GUI interface that sits on top of that for designing and testing that metadata. See, while it's great to write metadata by hand, YAML or JSON is not everybody's cup of tea. The console allows us to visually make these changes and then test those through the built-in API Explorer so that we're able to really understand exactly how our API will behave in production. Speaking of that API in production, that's exactly what the GraphQL engine does. The GraphQL engine takes the metadata to understand the entire data picture, and then it will process my inbound requests and break up those different query parts into the parts that the underlying data source understands. So to Postgres, it will take a query, it'll analyze that into a SQL statement and fire it off to Postgres. And for BigQuery, it'll do the same. For a microservice, generates a REST request or whatever else that is that my underlying data source requires. This is a fundamental part of how Hasura works, and it's really important to understand there are no resolvers being written by hand here. This is simply the way that Hasura is able to use an engine-driven approach to look at the metadata, figure out how does the data connect, and then execute that and resolve that real-time for your data projects. I hope those key concepts help you understand a little bit about Hasura, and we'll be looking at the hands-on part of that later on, as well as some additional videos understanding more of how to get started with Hasura.